Hi, it's Jennifer from Soul Source Tarot, and I'm here to do a reading for Scorpio. This is for Scorpio Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus, and this is for the next 7 days, okay? From the time that you watch it, 7 days. Now, keep in mind that this reading may not be for you. So, you know, it may not be for you. So if it's not for you, then you don't need to write any comments down below, you know, anything stupid, because it'll just be blocked and deleted. So if it triggers you in any way, then it is what it is. Then it probably was for you. Anyhow, goldfish, increase in material wealth or spiritual growth. So there is going to be an increase of material wealth or spiritual growth. What else do we have for Scorpio? Coins. Well, ain't that just dandy? Money will be coming to you. So there is definitely going to be an increase in the financial sector. Increase in material wealth or spiritual growth. Money will be coming to you. Desk. Pay attention to your work. Pay attention to you. It's probably going to be through a job. Okay, so you've got an increase of money. Increase of abundance here. What else do we have for Scorpio? Really pay attention to your work, okay? So what do we have for Scorpio? Just give them a chance. Somebody wants you to give them a chance. Apparently the universe is saying to do it, to just give them a chance. Ooh. Hit and run. So I'm not sure what that means. Hit and run can mean many different things, okay? Okay. That one came out. We have a younger man here. We have a younger man that is involved. There's going to be an increase. Money will be coming to you. Pay attention to your work. Younger man, hit and run. Just give them a chance. So who knows? What else do we have for Scorpio? Temperance is a card of evolution. It's a card of timing. Managing feelings, cooperating, accepting. This comes after death. So there's accepting that something is over. Accepting, that's what it is. It comes after a profound life change. It comes after a death. So I feel like this is accepting that something is over. Needing to accept that something is over. Going with the flow, managing your feelings. There's going to be a change. Obviously, there's going to be a profound life change. What do we have for Scorpio? It's exchanging something lesser for something better, so that's really good. It's a time of evolution. Resoluteness, determination, no compromises, unwavering focus, inner resolve, integrity, a test of character, self-examination. No compromises, unwavering focus. This is kind of reminds me of the hermit. So you're gaining some sort of life experience. You're gaining some sort of inner wisdom. I feel like your character is being tested. There is a test of character here. There's also some self-examination going on. You're evolving. You are definitely evolving, and you're healing. You know, the temperance comes after a major ending, which is a death, and it's a time of healing. It's profound self-healing. So you are going through a period of profound self-healing right now. Now the increase in wealth or spiritual growth, I do feel like you're going through a period of spiritual growth as well. This is definitely a time of evolution for you. money is going to be coming to you. There's somebody that wants you to give them a chance. Death. Death reversed. Now, death reversed, it still could be. It's a disaster. It could be an accident. It could be an incident. There's been some sort of stagnation. There's been a delay, okay? There's been indecision, held back by fear. Holding on is getting old. This could definitely be some sort of destruction. Could happen very suddenly. A new beginning is necessary, but there's been a delay. Chariot reversed. Two of Wands reversed. Or Ten of Wands reversed. That's on somebody else's side. Queen of Cups. Could be your side. I don't know. Usually I do the other person on this side. And what about you? Six of Cups reversed. Clinging to the past. Wheel of Fortune reversed. And Seven of Swords reversed. Now, all of you guys that are in fantasy land are going to say, oh, no, the other side's mine. Right? Seven of Swords reversed. Whew. Wheel of Fortune reversed and Six of Cups reversed. So whoever you are dealing with, is trying to control. They're trying to control. They have complete control over you right now, over your emotions. Anyhow, let's get back over to you. Six of Cups reversed, clinging to the past. I feel like right now you are clinging to the past. You're clinging to the memories of the past. Down there in your external Six of Cups reverse. That it's like you're focusing on the past. You are. It's almost like you're determined to not move forward. And I feel like you want to move forward, but you're stuck. You're stuck in the past. The Wheel of Fortune reverse is stuck. You're stuck in the past. Stuck in the memory. Stuck on everything that happened. Stuck on the deception. Why? Why this happened? Why did I get lied to? You know, stuck on the lie. Stuck on the betrayal. Seven of Swords reversed. Getting caught. Somebody's getting caught. The past is coming back to haunt them. And it's on your side. The Wheel of Fortune reversed. That's the past coming back to haunt you. The past. Six of Cups. That's the past. Okay. So, and some sort of deception, lies, cheating, whatever is coming back around to be dealt with now. It's on your side. I know that you don't want to hear that because nobody wants to hear bad shit about themselves. We've all done bad shit in our lives. Okay. Every single one of us has done bad shit. And you get paid back when karma decides to pay you back. Okay. Ain't no angels, okay? I mean, there's angels. There's angels. They've earned their wings through difficult situations. Anyhow, Seven of Swords reversed. Getting caught. Getting caught. Bad karma. Bad luck. This is a horrendous loss. Wheel of Fortune reversed. Shocking, unpredictable, horrendous loss. Past coming back around to be dealt with. Definitely clinging to the past. Reawakened memories of the past. Somebody is clinging to control. They got their foot in the wheel. There's karma coming back around. There's been some sort of lies. I feel like there's an enemy. I feel like there's an enemy in the camp. Somebody is plotting and planning. They may be plotting. This is my second Scorpio reading. I do feel like you have an enemy. I saw it. We had the Page of Swords. This person looked very angry. You do have an enemy in the camp. There's going to be some opposition. Somebody's going to be opposing you. And I feel like it's because of your, I feel like there's an unwillingness. There's a very fixed energy. There's an unwillingness to change your view, which you shouldn't. I mean, I understand where that comes from because it's your view. You have the right to have your own opinion. You have the right to have your own view. Anyhow, I do feel like you're going to be opposed. You're going to be facing some opposition. I feel like there's some outdated thinking here. I feel like it's time to let go. It's time to find a new approach. I feel like for some of you, you may not be looking where you're going. We have the Seven of Swords reversed and the Wheel of Fortune reversed. I mean, we have hit and run. I think that you need to be very, 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 very careful because I feel like you may be unaware that someone is headed towards you. So keep that in mind. Or something that has to do with a previous hit and run, and it may be coming back around at this time. I don't know if there was a hit and run, and now you're going to be dealing with the consequences. And hit and run can mean many different things. Okay, it can be a car accident, it can be a one night stand, it can be a punch, it can be a hit. You know, so we do have a hit and run here. that is surfacing this week. I also feel like we have malice with the Seven of Swords reversed. We have somebody here that has no moral conscience, and that's what's coming back around to deal with, be dealt with now. There has been some cheating. There's been lies. They've been getting away with it up until now. Here we go. Everything is about to just blow up. I did have the Tower in the last reading. So anyhow, I feel like it's going to be very, very emotional. I feel like there's going to be an ending here. We have the Death card and the Wheel of Fortune and the Ten of Wands. And it's interesting because they're right lined up together. Those are completions. Okay. Those are all completions, but there's been resistance. There's been reluctance. There's been denial. There's been trying to hold on to something that is weighing you down, and it's getting old for quite some time. I think that there's been a lot of lies. There's been a lot of deception. There's really no victory here. There's no success. I'm putting my hands in the back of the chair. I do it all the time. There's the chair. Whoever you're dealing with is not liking the outcome. They are overwhelmed. They want to prove a point. They want to prove a point. They don't like the outcome of the situation, so they want to prove a point. I feel like you are going to be challenged. You are going to be challenged by somebody this week. Somebody is coming in. I feel like this person is angry. They're angry. They're emotional. They're in their feelings. They can't master their emotions right now. They're trying to prove a point, and I feel like they're going to challenge you. You're going to be challenged, whoever you're dealing with. I think it could be a Cancer. Could be a Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. Could also be an Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. Whoever you're dealing with is making a conscious change. They are making a conscious decision, and I feel like they're doing it out of anger. And emotions. They're doing it out of anger and emotions. The Chariot reversed is unable to master emotions. It's emotions all over the place. It's an emotional outburst ahead, and it could, I'm not sure if there is even an accident here, okay, because, or they may try to play it off as an accident. I mean, the Chariot reversed is a car or a vehicle coming to a stop, and it could definitely be an accident, because we have this hit and run. So I'm not sure what is going on. Something to do with a vehicle coming to a dead stop, or putting a stop to something, even if it's not a vehicle. Somebody is about to put a stop to something. They're not happy with the outcome. They're not happy, okay? Ten of Wands reversed, that is making a conscious change, letting something go, dropping a burden, letting this go. It's time to let this go. We can't keep holding on to this, and it's time to go. I mean, that's what I hear. Making a conscious change, making a conscious decision. Okay. Six of Wands reverse. I was going to clarify the Ten of Wands reverse. Six of Wands reverse is a fail. Okay. It's not a victory. This is somebody that has abused their power. This is a disgrace. It's losing. This is unwelcome news. Losing. We have a loser here. We have somebody here that has lost, or they're losing. They're losing a battle, or they did lose a battle. I don't know if they cheated. Not happy with an outcome. Not happy with a loss. Not wanting to let go. Not wanting to lose. Four of Cups. Next to the Queen of Cups. Discontent. We have somebody here that is discontent. They're overanalyzing things. They're not really happy with their current circumstances. Somebody could even be drinking and driving. And I may have said that in the last one as well. We have all these drinkings. And I see grieving over a loss, because if we add the Four of Cups to the Ace of Cups that's in there, that's the Five of Cups. Somebody is really grieving. They are really, really grieving over a loss. And I feel like they are about to take action because they don't like that they were let go, or they don't like that they lost. So they don't like the loss. So somebody is about to take action.
but they're not going to win. There's a lot. There's still a loss here. There's no victory. Six of Wands reverse and the Chariot reverse. This is not a win, okay? It's not a win in any way, shape, or form. We may have somebody here that's trying to emotionally manipulate somebody. They're using emotional blackmail to win a situation. They're being ignored, you know, or the truth has been ignored. I feel like there's some sort of ignorance here. We have somebody here that something about drinking, maybe drinking and driving and getting caught. Or we have somebody here that is just really, really angry. They're really, really angry. And maybe they're driving too fast. I don't know. We do have this hit and run. Anyhow, I do think that you need to be darn careful. No progress. We have a one-hit wonder here. And again, we could have the hit and run. One hit and run in a sexual manner. I mean, somebody could be coming in saying all the right words. You know, they're saying, I love you. This person has been abandoned. They've been neglected. They just want to fill a void. You know, that could be the hit and run. I think that you are about to be played in some way. There's no staying power here. There's no victory. This is a loss. Chariot reverse, Six of Wands reverse. It's a loss. It's nothing that you can hold on to. It's a loss. It is. And it's been ignored. It's like ignoring it. And I feel like maybe you're ignoring it. Maybe you're ignoring that it's a loss. Shocking, unpredictable loss. Deception, lies, cheating. Somebody's been cheating. They've been thinking they're getting caught. Somebody's getting caught. They're getting caught in their lies. They're getting caught. There's an enemy. I feel like we have an enemy here that is disguised as a friend that is telling all. Five of Coins. Five of Coins is hardship. It's abandonment. It's being left out. It's victim mentality as well. We have somebody here that is feeling very, very, very alone. You know, they need some sort of attention. They need help. And they're going to be seeking it. They are, and they may be seeking it through negative attention. There is negative attention here. There absolutely is. It's because this person is highly competitive and likes to win, and they've lost, and they need that boost. They need that ego boost. Making a conscious change. Somebody's going to be doing something. They don't like to lose. They want to win. They're going to be acting on their feelings. They're feeling abandoned. They're feeling neglected. They're not happy. They're not happy. So get prepared. I think that you got somebody, something is going to happen. We got somebody here that is very upset. They're very angry. They're in their feelings. They may be expressing their feelings, and it may start off as all cheery and it ends badly. Just saying. Something from the past is coming back around. For sure. I feel like it has to do with another water sign, Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio. This person is very egotistical, extremely egotistical, emotions all over the place. There's karma here. It ain't good. Eight of Coins reversed next to the Chariot reversed. That's something not working out. Somebody's not putting in much effort. They're not trying hard enough. They're not really interested in working out. It's not going to work out. They're not going to put in much effort. This is somebody who cannot master their emotions at this time. They're looking for attention. They've been rejected. Somebody is coming towards you that has been neglected. They have been rejected. Okay, this is a hit and run. And they're angry and they're upset and they're looking for attention. Somebody is looking for some love. They're looking for some love from you. This person has no staying power whatsoever. None. None, 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 none. Giving up. There's also somebody here that is giving up. They're giving up a battle. They're overwhelmed. They're done hanging on. So this is another whole story. It's another whole story. It's not you because you're on this side. This is the person that's over here. And I know that a lot of you want to put yourself on the most positive side. That's not fucking reality. Somebody is giving up. They're giving up. They're not interested. They're not interested in this. They aren't. They're listening to their intuition. I feel like this person has held on too long. They don't want to do this anymore. They're giving up the battle. They're letting go. They're done holding on. It's coming to a dead stop. Something. It's like there's, and I know that you guys are going to say this is you. I feel like you're on this side. I know that everybody only wants the fucking positive side and it makes me sick. Seven of Swords reversed. Wheel of Fortune reversed. Stuck in the past. Stuck in the past, clinging to the past. The past coming back to haunt you. Clinging to the past, lying to yourself. Whoever you are dealing with, if they do come around, it's for a hit and run, okay? It's for a one-night stand. It's not for love. There's also somebody here, and it's another whole story, that is giving up. They're giving up a battle. They're done. They're not putting in any more effort. They don't want this to go anywhere. They don't want to. They don't want to hold on to it. They're ready. They're ready to just let it all go. Not interested. I'm not interested in a relationship with you. I'm not interested. I'm more focused on myself. I'm more focused on my self-love. I'm more focused on something else. So I feel like there is somebody that is abandoning you. But I also feel like that Temperance card, everything happens for a reason. This is healing after an ending, after death. So something is ending. I think it's sudden. It's a sudden ending. I don't think it's a good time to start new things. I think that profound self-healing is needed. I think there is a younger man involved that you may become aware of during this time. Maybe there's a younger man that can help you to heal from whatever this situation is, and you just need to give that person a chance. I feel like you're also going to be receiving a message from somebody that changes everything. Five of Coins, that is abandoned, neglected, and then not interested. Four of Cups, not interested. I'm not, and that's the other person. There's somebody here that is not interested in holding on. It's getting old. It's like they're not interested in putting in any effort. Eight of Coins reversed underneath it. They're not interested. They're not interested. This person is emotionally all over the place, okay? Chariot reversed. They may have some anger issues. I feel like we have an emotional outburst ahead. I do. not going anywhere. It's not going to work out. It's not going to work out. There's no, this person is giving up. They don't plan on putting in any effort. Somebody that you're dealing with may have another love interest. That's what it looks like to me. And maybe that's why they've been ignoring you or neglecting you or something like that. Maybe you need, the Temperance card is a card of acceptance. Accepting the death, accepting that it's over. So I feel like you're going through a period of acceptance right now. But I feel like you've been waiting. That's what is this? Just give them a chance. Let's get the card on that. What is this? Just give them a chance. Queen of Coins, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. The Queen of Coins is somebody of value, okay? Somebody that is very grounded, very practical, very realistic, okay? Maybe you have somebody new here. There probably is a new opportunity here with the Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. It's not the past, because the past is reversed. Somebody wants you to give them a chance. Or maybe you're being called to give them a chance. This is somebody who doesn't move fast. The Queen of Coins is somebody that is very solid, very down to earth, slow. This person builds a strong foundation with hard work and determination. So you do have an earth sign here, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, who can probably bring you some sort of stability. But this person appears, it looks to be very beautiful. Okay, but I feel like this person is very practical, very realistic, may not be your usual type. This person is not all wishy-washy, and I feel like you have a couple of options here. I feel like maybe you've been with somebody who's really wishy-washy and feelings all over the place, and you know, it feels like this person may have abandoned you because they're very fluid. I think that you've been with somebody that is very, very fluid, you know, very all over the place if you think about it, just in and out. You know, you've been with somebody who's, they skirt around the problems, whatever. They skirt around the problems. You think about the rocks and the water. They just go around it, you know, and they come back around whenever they feel like it. You're dealing with an earth sign. Earth signs are very solid from the beginning. Okay? Totally different. So anyhow, I do believe there is somebody here that you need to give a chance. It's somebody that is very practical, down to earth, solid, slow moving. I also feel like you need to know your value. Maybe you need to give yourself a chance. Maybe you need to focus on yourself, focus on your independence, focus on your self-value. Emperor reverse, loss of control, angry, upset. Things are out of control. We have somebody here that has deserted you in your time of need. And I think that you need to accept it. You may have something to do with a father figure. Giving up a battle. Somebody is giving up a battle. They're giving up. You also have somebody here that is abusive. You know, if you think about the Emperor in reverse, this person is not very experienced. They're on the wrong side of the law. They don't care who they hurt. They just like to be in that position of authority that they shouldn't even be in. Anyhow, we could keep going, but we're not going to. I feel like you're going through a period of evolution. I feel like you need to stop holding on to something that is weighing you down. I feel like it's time to take a new approach. Be very, very, very careful. You do have an enemy. You have an enemy here. There could be a hit and run. Good luck.